A new warning from scientists suggesting the Earth may be on the verge of another mass extinction, similar to the one that killed the dinosaurs. It happened five times in the past 540 million years, but this time around, experts say we may be able to stop it. Michio Kaku is a physics professor at City University of New York and author of the new book, Physics of the Future. That we're going to be looking forward to the new book, of course. All right, Dr. Kaku, getting right to it. So which species would be most at risk?
Well, so far, if you analyze the last few hundred years of life on the Earth, human activity apparently has wiped out 1.4% of all plant and animal species, and it is 100 to 1,000 times faster than normal because of human population, development, pollution, over-harvesting. And if you take a look at a zoo, many of the zoo animals that our children love, we may find them going extinct. The tiger, for example, may go extinct. Many of the familiar zoo animals, bears, and realize that 18,000 species are at risk.
And what about climate control? How does that, what role does it play?
Yeah, climate change is also involved in this thing. Independent of where climate change comes from, we see that the seasons are changing. Summers are getting longer. Winters are getting shorter on average. And we always say that the early bird catches the worm, but that assumes that the worm and the bird are synchronized. Many of these cycles, the natural cycles, are being thrown into disarray, meaning, for example, droughts in China going on right now, perhaps famine in certain areas. So we humans cannot be divorced from what's happening in the natural world.
We can't be divorced. Is it something we can do about it? I guess you said pollution is one thing we can do. But so what happens, doctor, if there is not this sort of scientific pruning? Would the earth be overrun with all sorts of creatures?
Well, evolution says survival of the fittest. And so far, we humans are among the fittest. But we are also at the top of the food chain, the top of the pyramid, and it wouldn't take much to dislodge us from being at the top of the food chain.
So who could outrank us at that top of that food chain? You know what animals I need to look out for.
Well, in science fiction, of course, the insects take over. But look at something very simple. We are dependent on just a few crops, wheat, rice, just a few crops, and if a blight were to wipe out these crops, then a huge chunk of humanity would starve to death because we're so dependent on just a few plants and animals for our existence.
So should we expand our menu, so to speak, or is there something else that the Earth provides that we should be looking at?
We should be wary of over-harvesting. For example, over-harvesting the oceans. We have dragnets, which in principle could drag the entire oceans. That's how efficient our technology is. Also, wheat production we have to worry about because water. Water is the key to wheat production, and there are going to be perhaps water wars in the future.
And are you concerned about that water wars and that we may run out of water?
Well, there will always be water on the Earth. The question is the cost and what it would take to extract it, to desalinate it, to divert it, to irrigate. And so the cost of certain kinds of commodities could start to rise. So just because we're at the top of the food chain doesn't mean that we're invulnerable to what's happening outside where biodiversity is being threatened.
You mentioned, we have to go, but you mentioned insects could overrun the Earth.
Well, that's science fiction.
Yeah, but the cockroaches, they never seem to go away, doctor. We got to figure out a way to get rid of them. Mm-hmm. All right, Dr. Michio Kaku, thank you so much. And your new book we're looking out for is Physics of the Future.